Hello guys, welcome to Bank Exams Today. Today our lesson is 5 Golden Rules for Seating Arrangement. And this lesson is presented by me. My name is Burgi. So before we jump into the 5 Golden Rules, let us discuss regarding IBPS PO 2017. In IBPS PO 2017 prelim examinations, 20 to 25 questions out of 35 questions in reasoning section are from seating arrangement. Please make a note or please do remind how important is a seating arrangement in prelims. Not only in prelims, in main examinations also you will be getting maximum questions in seating arrangement or puzzles topic. Now before going to the rules, just some points you need to keep your brain or you need to train your brain. From my side, this is not a T20 match. What I mean by this is, just before the exam or just with few hours of practice, you cannot master the seating arrangement questions. This is not a T20 match. Just practicing once in a fortnight, you will never crack a seating arrangement within the given time. Please remember guys, anyone can crack the seating arrangement question if he is allotted 20 minutes per question. But the challenge or the task or the efficiency lies in solving the question with the stipulated time. Only it is possible if you are having enough practice. Next, it is test match initially. What I mean by this is, whenever you start practicing seating arrangement questions, it will be very dry and boring and it is very frustrating and brain tickling thing. Initially, it is very hard to solve a seating arrangement question of level 2 or 3. Believe me, initially it is very hard and nothing is interested when it is hard. Like a test match. Test match is a 5-day format. It will be very dry, no hard hittings or no entertainment as in T20. But believe me, if you keep on practicing, you will enjoy solving the seating arrangement questions. So please feed these points to your brain while you're practicing, which will definitely help you to score good marks in the exam. Do not run blindly without hitting the ball. When you are playing a cricket match, assume you are batting. So without hitting the ball, if you run between the wickets, definitely you'll face the run out. So similarly here also, without reading the complete information regarding the question. For example, a seating arrangement question is given in a 10 lines saying that it is a circular arrangement, 8 persons facing around this circle, and some information right or left to the person. Everything is given in 9 lines. In the last line, he is given some are facing inside and some are facing outside. If you do not read this, definitely you will solve this question facing inside. That's the reason why I'm saying read complete information and step into the problem. Just don't blindly put the points into the diagram directly. Just understand the sense of the problem. Never try to be Dhoni in the exam. So in the exam, what does Dhoni does in every match regularly? He comes in the last over or whenever there is 15 runs in a one over, he comes and he will hit and complete the match. But in real life, in your exam, this is not possible. Don't waste last 2 or 3 minutes by touching a hard puzzle or hard seating arrangement. Whenever you are in the last 2 or 3 minutes of this exam, go for a puzzle with least information given. Within 4 or 5 lines, definitely a puzzle would be given in prelims exam. Within 4 or 5 lines, it would complete the matter. Choose such puzzles in the last 2 or 3 minutes. Learn every shot before the match. So before going to the match, either it may be Dhoni or Kohli or Sehwag or Sachin, everyone learns all the shots. You also do the similar thing. Learn all the formats of the seating arrangement. Either it may be circular, circular facing in and facing out, circular with blood relations, or rectangular, anything. You please practice each and every format before the exam and don't forget to look the recent examinations seating arrangement or any questions of recent examinations, because every examination a new surprise. We can expect a new surprise from every examination and every single question. practice good number of mocks. The main difference between the selection and not selecting for an exam is practice of mocks. If you practice mocks, you can reduce number of scrolls. For example, a person is attempting directly the exam and he is having a question and a scroll bar. Definitely he will use more times this scroll bar, up and down, up and down. If a person practice and he is having scroll bar, he will use less time, less number of times. Definitely it will be going, it would save your time so that some more marks you can gain compared to the others. So these are some of the important points while solving the lengthy or reasoning questions, especially seating arrangement and puzzles. Now let us look into the rule. So rule number one, always start arrangement with 100% fixed information. For example, I've taken a question, 8 persons are namely A to H are seating around a circular table. So first given it is a circular table. A is sitting third to the right of B, C is sitting opposite to D, who is third left of person opposite to A, and so on. Some information like this is given for you. So what is the first step? You will draw a circle and 8 persons in it. Here are the 8 persons. So out of all the points, from which point you need to start the question? Always start from this. A is sitting third to the right of B. So first, position of A is given with respect to D. So first fix the position B. And please make a note, no information regarding facing inside or outside is given here. So whenever there is no information given placing inside or outside, by default you take placing inside, facing inside. So I have placed B here, who is facing inside. What is the information given? A is sitting third to the right of B. So this is the first right, second right and third right. In this way you start the puzzle. Or not only there, I will take again another possibility. I'll take B here, or I'll take B here, wherever you can take, but these two positions with respect to each other are fixed. So please make a note of that. I think I missed this point, right? No one can win a match in a single ball or over. What is mean by this is, never keep in mind that with only single diagram you can crack the seating arrangement. Definitely one possible diagram cannot give you the answer. You should be in a mood that you need to draw more number of diagrams or all the possible diagrams. Let us see rule number two. For a closed figure, either it may be circle, rectangle, octagon, etc., arrangement only sit opposite to each other when there are even number of persons. What is meant by this is, for example, I am having a circle. In one question it is given 8 persons are accommodated in circle, in other question it is given only 7 persons are accommodated in circle, and in individual questions it is asked who is opposite to A. For this question you cannot get answer from the second case, only you can get opposite person in the first case. What is meant by this is, only if there are even number of persons for any closed diagram, you will get exactly opposite position. But not for odd number of persons sitting in a closed figure, you cannot get exactly opposite person. So this is the rule 2. Now let us see rule 3. This is very important, and versus who. First, see here, in a circular arrangement, there are 4 persons A, B, C, D sitting in the following way. A is right of B, who is left of C. What he said? There are 4 persons, 1, 2, 3, 4, sitting in a circular arrangement, A, B, C, D. But in a single line, he completed the arrangement. A is right of B, who is left of C. So first, I will start with B, because position of A is given with respect to A. So I will start with B. A is right of B, who is left of C. Now, observe this who. For which person this who is referred? Either to A or B. So whenever you observe who, it is referred to the immediate person. So B is immediate left of C. So position of C is here. Whenever there is no information regarding facing inside or outside, you by default you take it as inside. Whenever C is facing inside, this will become left and this will become right. So from this statement, what you can observe, A is right of B, who is left of C? So B is left of C. And similarly, whenever B is facing inside, this is the left and this is the right. So where B should be, A should be accommodated, here or here. So in this place, A is accommodated. The left person is T. So I'll draw again neatly. So this is the final arrangement. Now, in a circular arrangement, there are four persons, A, B, C, D. A is right of B and is left of C. Here are the four persons, A, B, C, D. A is right of B and left of C. Now, N refers to B or A. Here, N refers to A. Whenever who is given, it is referred to immediate person. Immediate person. Whenever N is given, it is referred to first person. Among these three persons, who is the first person here? A. So whenever who is given, it is referred to immediate. Whenever end is given, it is referred to first person. Now, A is right of B. I'll start again with B. A is right of B and is left of C. For example, I'll take A here. A is right of B. It is satisfied. If you take C here, whenever C is facing inside, this will become left and this will become right. So this condition is also satisfied. So in this way, whenever and is there, it referred to first person. Whenever who is there, it refers to the immediate person. Now rule number four, left versus immediate left, left versus immediate right. Let us take an example. Five persons standing in a row, namely X, Y, Z, P, A. I'll draw five persons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here are the five persons. No one sits to the left of the vowel. So who is the vowel here? A. So if I take A here and here also, whenever it is not given, either the persons are facing north or facing south, by default you take north because it would be easy for solving. When you take north, your left becomes left and your right becomes right. So I'm taking north, this is the left and this is the right. What is the first one given? No one sits to the left of oval. Only three persons to the right of X. X sits immediate left of Y and left to the Z. Z does not sit at the extreme end. For example, no one sits to the left of oval. Who is the oval here? A. If I take oval here, there are persons to the left of A. If I take A here, there are persons. If I take A here, there are some persons. If I take A here, there is one person. So the only chance is here, because from here there is no person to the left of A. Only three persons sit right of X. So this is the only position for X, because to the right of X there are three persons here. X is immediate left of Y and left to the Z. Observe here, I have placed N. Whenever N, it refers to the first person, that is X. So X is immediate left of Y and left of Z. But what are the positions here? Z can be accommodated here or here. Z does not sit at the extreme end. So this is ruled out. The only position is here. Who is the left out person? P. So in this way, you can differentiate between the immediate left and here is the immediate left and this is just left. Identify the left and right in the given arrangement. For any closed circuit or closed figure, take, this is a shortcut, go clockwise rotation. If you need to place left side, go anti-clockwise rotation. If you need to place right side, these are the important points you need to remember. And please make a note, aspirants should not be in a hurry. Aspirants should be speed enough, but not in a hurry. There is a 100-mile difference between speed and hurry. Thank you.